All right, how's everybody doing today? I know you're interested in how I make arrowheads and spearheads, cool little points like this, out of glass, out of stone. And before we do that, I'm actually going to talk to you about the tools that I use and the tools that were traditionally used. To make arrowheads, the process is called flint napping, like you're napping or hitting at the flint.
The raw materials, such as this flint or toilet porcelain or glass, has to be broken into smaller pieces, like these flint chips, and then finally factored into these delicate little sharp serrated points. To break the rock into smaller pieces, Aboriginals, native people, would have probably used an antler or a rock. Modern flint nappers use these heavy, weighted, copper-capped boppers. To do the fine, detailed touch-up work, primitive people probably just used an antler tip. This is just a broken antler, or possibly whittled down wood, a hard wood like this oak. This is an antler that I used for flint napping when I first started, and it works great, but the tip does wear down fairly quickly. So from there, I progressed into just using slices of the antler tied onto a handle, and then eventually into the Iron Age with a steel nail. Again, this end would be for breaking the rock, this end would be for doing the fine work. Then I found that copper really works the best. It's actually hard to find copper nails that are solid copper, so I bought these online and they come in a variety of sizes. And finally, I worked up to a plastic handle with a removable small metal nail. This is a horseshoe nail that the base has been cut off, and these are cheap and you can file them down. And again, they wear out, but not as quickly as deer antler.
Let me show you how to break some chips off of the main rock, off the flint, and I'll start with the primitive and go to the more advanced. So here's a deer antler, and I'm just going to whack and support the piece. The piece will break off underneath, and again, you can cut yourself, so be prepared for blood. But I'm just going to take a small piece off right here, bracing my hand against my leg, and give it a good whack. All right, and here could be the making of an arrowhead. Now let's try it with a rock. Same idea, just hitting the edge in a downward motion, supporting this, and then trying to break off a small flake. There we go, could make another arrowhead. Finally, let me try the copper bopper. Same idea, hit downward, support the piece, try not to cut yourself. Again, I've got a nice little piece, almost looks like an arrowhead, doesn't it? Moving on to the next step, I'm going to use these antlers and this horseshoe nail as a pressure flaker, that's what it's called, to break off little tiny flakes on the edge. And I'm going to zoom in and get closer, but I've also got a piece of heavy leather to support my leg, and I also use this rubber pad. You could use a piece of leather, but you've got to protect your hand. You don't want too many of those. As it is, this piece is razor sharp, and it could probably be hafted on a stick to be used as a spearhead or put on a shaft to act as an arrowhead. But authentic arrowheads are more durable, and we get rid of that really fine feather edge by taking off a series of flakes. Press it down onto the leather and just start breaking. Breaking small flakes off. So you can see here are some of the flakes. Very, very, very tiny flakes coming off. Creating a serrated edge that's more durable, still sharp, but a lot more durable. Now let me show you the horseshoe nail. Same idea, pressure flaking, using pressure to take off flakes along the edge to make it a serrated edge. It did a fast series of small flakes, and you can see how serrated and sharp and how much more sturdier that edge is going to be. To do these techniques takes a lot of practice. It took me several years to actually get good at this. There was a point in my life when I was flint napping every single night after work. You can start simple and advance pretty quickly. Look at YouTube videos, and I'm going to be posting more.